That's probably why they were trying to find the one for already.
Financing options through Care Credit. And why Lorelei? Because it's your eyes. The Lorelei Clinic, a better vision for you.
This is Tim Cronin-Letta, CEO of InFirst Bank. Here at InFirst Bank, we are celebrating our 100-year anniversary. May I introduce you to one of our over 100 amazing InFirst team members working for you.
Hello, this is Misty Wilson, Customer Support Center Manager. I have been working for InFirst Bank for 16 years, and I couldn't imagine being anywhere else. I love being part of the InFirst Bank team because we are always striving to help our customers and our community.
Hello, this is Lisa Fitzgerald, Operations Representative with InFirst Bank. What I love about working at InFirst is being part of a dedicated team who treat customers and coworkers like family. Being a hometown bank, we are invested in the growth of our community and would like to thank those who are already a part of our family and invite others to join us for many years to come.
Thank you, thank you for you since 1922.
Welcome back to the new Anchor In pregame show. DJ Gould, Eric, getting with you, waiting for both the teams to come out here. What a beautiful night in Punxsutawney for week three. Again, the Chucks coming in at 2-0 along with Red Bank Valley. Punxsutawney, 56-0 win over Bradford in week one, and then a 37-16 win over Kane last week. Red Bank coming in, like I said, 2-0. 53-8 win over Smithport in their first week, and then a big game last week against Carn City. They came out on top 25-15. Last year, Red Bank beat Punxsy 40-14, and then it was 54-14 2 years ago. So a big test for the Chucks here. I think Red Bank's coming in ranked eighth in their state in single A, I believe, this year thus far. went to, what, the semis last year.
Welcome to 19. There'll be some special events going on this evening to honor 9/11, our veterans, active military, and all first responders. It is important we continue to thank and honor these brave individuals who make our freedom possible. Don't forget to thank a veteran or a first responder this weekend in honor of 9/11. These activities this evening are sponsored by the Future First Responders Club of the Punxsutawney Area High School. You're going to be out there cutting wood, though. That's what you got to get your wood cut for the winter.
I just missed out today. I saw on Facebook there were two free cords, and by the time I was done with school, they were gone.
So we'll take another break in our new Anchor In pregame show. We come back. We will get you set here, Chuck's Bulldogs, right here on Laurel Eye Clinic, Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy. 2 minutes.
Now, when the ads are on, we're not telling over the ads, are we?
Hey, how many seconds?
2 minutes.
2 minutes? Okay.
Patients with the latest personalized cancer treatments and access to breakthrough clinical trials. New advances in cancer prevention, diagnosis, and treatment are being developed every day and brought to you close to home. You are not alone in your fight against cancer. Punxsutawney Area Hospital and Hillman Cancer Center are committed to providing you with the knowledge, inspiration, and specialty cancer care you need so you can face your diagnosis with confidence. Why travel for world-class cancer care when you don't have to? We're here for you as a part of the Punxsutawney community. Learn more about the UPMC Hillman Cancer Care Center at the Punxsutawney Area Hospital by visiting www.pah.org or call the office at 814-938-5212. At Punxsutawney Area Hospital, patients come first.
You're listening to Punxsy Chuck's Football on Fox Sports, FM 100.9. We know do-it-yourself. Napa Midtown Auto Parts, your locally owned and operated Napa store. We're a proud supporter of local sports, and we're here for professionals, auto enthusiasts, and do-it-yourselfers. Come see us for all your car care needs, and we can custom mix your paint, and we can put your custom mix in aerosol cans. Come see us for details. Napa Midtown Auto Parts, great people, great products, great Napa know-how. Open 7:30 to 6 p.m. Monday through Friday, Saturday, 8 to 3. Find us, 110 South Gilpin Street, Punxsy, Napa Midtown Auto Parts. Ready for the game? Are you sure? What about your eyes? You'll want to be able to see all the action clearly. Dr. Gribble and everyone at Gribble Eye Care can help.
You depend on your eyes. Depend on Gribble Eye Care. No referrals necessary. Schedule your appointment in person or at 938-4777. Not just cataracts. Get your full line of eye care at Gribble Eye Care.
And eyelid and diabetic procedures, too. No need to go out of town. Find them at Punxsy Hospital, second floor, suite 2500. Gribble Eye Care.
Get the XL Double Deal from Punxsy Pizza. 2 16-inch extra-large pizzas with 12 slices covered in pepperoni for only $26.49. The Double Deal at Punxsy Pizza. Call 938-8132. Think about pizza one more time. XL Double Deal from Punxsy Pizza. 2 16-inch extra-large pizzas with 12 slices covered in pepperoni for only $26.49. The XL Double Deal at Punxsy Pizza. Call 938-8132.
Expires 8/31/22. Not valid with any other offer.
You're watching your favorite show, and you get a text. Looks like you just bought a diamond bracelet for $5,900 in Las Vegas. Or at least someone tried to. See, you've got Card Valet from Marion Central Bank. You can turn your debit card on and off when you want, set spending limits, and receive alerts when your card is used. Download the app to your phone, register your card, and you're done. And you can get back.
But how glorious was he? Left boy, come back man. Still many.
Thank you.
McDonald's team will make it fresh for you and serve it with icy cold drinks. Looking for work? Go online at mchire.com. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
You're listening to Punxsutawney Chuck Football on Fox Sports, FM 100.9.
Welcome back. Captain's out on the field here. Well, that'll do it for our new anchor in pregame show. Seth Moore, Quentin Vogel, Landon Peterson, and Justin Miller for Punxsutawney. Cam Wagner, the quarterback for Redbank Valley, is out there along with number five. That is Tate Minnick, another player we'll be calling quite a bit there. Carson Rupp. And I believe Cole Bish. So
when you start reading those last names for Redbank Valley, you could be announcing a football game in 1982.
That's about it. Punxsutawney's going to receive to start the game as Redbank won the toss and they deferred. So Punxsutawney will get the ball to start this game. And what an important drive right away, Eric.
Absolutely. Score or not, if Punxsutawney can just get the ball moving. If we can move the ball early on, that's what happened in Kane last week. They were able to move the ball early, and they kind of stolen it momentum that lasted the whole first half, and they carried it through the entire game.
So let's see, coming out here for Redbank. Looks like kicker will be number 21. That's Owen Klaus. Kicker for the Bulldogs. And for the Chucks, it's Zeke Bennett, Noah Weaver, and Brett Dean back there deep. Now, there's some speed out there right there.
Brett Dean definitely has some speed. He's one of the fastest guys in the district.
There's a lot of speed in that back looking for this kickoff as Krause is set to go. And we're underway. Chuck's Bulldogs as Noah Weaver will pick it up at about the 12, right up the middle. Has some room and brought down just short of the 30. We'll mark at the 29. Brought down there by Cole Bish. And the Chucks will start first and 10 from their 29. To start this game of the 2-0 teams.
Away from the ball, there was Landon Peterson just put a block on the kicker coming downfield. And that's the kind of thing that needs to happen on every play. End it with an exclamation.
So they'll actually spot the ball, knows the football is on the 30, so we'll call it the 30, first and 10. Seth Moore, the quarterback for the Chucks, he'll set it up with twins to each side. Bennett in the backfield. It's a handoff to Bennett. He's up the middle. He'll get two or three. Give him three to the 33. Bring up second down and seven. Nice little counter play for the Chucks off the right side to start the game. And 3 yards a clip is a first down, Eric. Three yards at a time is a first down.
That's the way the running game looked early in Kane. And they were able to wear down that side.
Now they'll move Miller in as an extra blocker. Ball's on the ground, and then Seth able to just get it to Zeke as the snap is a little bit low, and it'll be a no gain. Actually, they're going to have Seth was on his knee, so he's going to lose 4 yards and brings up third down and 11. So again, we want to thank everybody for tuning in. This is the Punxsutawney Shop and Save first quarter of action. The Chucks going right to left in their camo jerseys. I forgot to mention that. Chucks in the full camo jerseys tonight. As, again, Moore in the back from the shotgun. He back to pass. Rolls to his right, looks out to the flat, and it's almost picked off. Boy, Aiden Ortz read that play intended for Miller. And, boy, that could have been six real quick.
That was tight. You're going to throw that ball out there in the flat. You've got to put a little more mustard on it.
Well covered by the Bulldogs. It'll bring up 4th-11. The Chucks forced a punt. And I'll tell you what, Eric, I don't know in this season if the Chucks had a 3-and-out. This may be their first one. If not, maybe one other one. That's it. So Peyton Hetrick will set to punt. It'll be Mason Klaus and Ashton Kale back deep. Nice high punt by Hetrick, taken by Klaus. Klaus across the 40. He has some room. He goes to the far side, and there is nobody over there except Hetrick. Can he catch him? He cuts it back in, and he is into the end zone for about a 65-yarder or so, and that's how this game is going to start with Redbank taking it back. That was Mason Klaus on a punt return for a touchdown, and with 10:26 to go, Redbank leading 6-0.
That was something last week that Punxsutawney did an excellent job on, was kick coverage. And Redbank just did a real nice job opening the running lanes on that.
Redbank will. They kind of set up weird here, but they're going to go for two. Yep, they're going to go for the extra point now, and this is Owen Klaus again. He'll set for the extra point. Holder is Mason Klaus, who just ran that in from about 65 yards. Extra points right down the middle. Redbank leads 7-0. 10:26 to go here, first quarter. You're listening to a Laurel Eye Clinic Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsutawney.
LS Tractor, do more for
how long for this break?
Just 30 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah, if I don't tell you, Luke, just do it in 30 seconds, okay?
Okay.
Move it. Stop by your local participating dealer and join the growing LS Tractor family today.
Get more from LS Tractors, available at 310 Lawn and Garden, Route 310 between Reynoldsville and Punxsutawney. Click over to 310lawnandgarden.com.
LS Tractor, simply more.
Welcome back. Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. Well, it was about a 65-yard punt return by Mason Klaus after Chucks were three and out. Extra point was good. Redbank leading 7-0 here, 10:26 to go, first quarter. This one's taken by Brett Dean at the 20 on the kickoff. He gets up across the 30, mark it at the 31-yard line, and Chucks will start their second possession of the night here in the Punxsutawney Shop and Save first quarter.
Punxsutawney needs to take a deep breath right here. Slow things down. Get a drive going. And bring themselves back in the game.
Got Landon Martz is going to be in the backfield. We're going to do that double wing. Peterson to the right, Miller to the left here. Moore under center. It's going to be a handoff up the middle to Martz. And Martz with a hard five yards. We'll give him five, second down five. And that's the difference in Landon Martz this year. He's learned to run, his head's up, and he's tough. He will run hard.
Yeah, Martz will.
And he has some speed. He really does.
He will not avoid contact.
Bunch formation. Miller on a sweep. It's going to be a pitch to him to the right. He tries to turn the corner and brought down nicely there by Ashton Kale. Give him a couple more yards up across the 35 to the 38. Bring up third down and three. Need to get the ball just to the 41-yard line. Chucks, no huddle. They check the bands, quickly get to the line. That double wing look again. Now they'll check off to a different play. Plenty of time on the play clock. Clock running at 9:20 here in the first quarter. Martz up the middle. He'll have the first down. Needed three, give him four, maybe even five. Yep, give him five. They'll mark it at the 43-yard line. First and 10 for the Chucks. This double wing look, you know, you got somebody power up the middle. You still got two guys that can turn the corner. Zeke will get it on a sweep coming this way. Cuts it back up front. He'll get 5 yards as he gets across the 45, make it to 46, so he'll get 4 yards. Second down and six.
This is what Punxsutawney needs to do. Just pick them up 3-4 yard chunks
Zeke
at a time.
With a double lead this time. He'll cross the 50 into Redbank territory. And he'll be about a yard short at the 48-yard line of the Bulldogs. Third down, one. And if we can just, and we're just pounding the ball at the middle, and that's the key.
Yep.
You get 4 or 5 yards of the clip, you can run a lot of time off the clock. We're down to 8:15 in the running clock here in the Punxsutawney Shop and Save first quarter. Chucks do trail 7-0 to the Bulldogs. Moore under center again. This is a little counterplay, and that's Justin Miller with the carry, and he's going to pick up 4 or 5 as he crosses the 45 to about the 44-yard line. give them 4 yards, second down, six.
This is a good look. We're seeing the ball go to three different guys right now out of the backfield, and that's keeping them thinking. Martz has three carries right now for 15 yards, and if we can keep those going.
Second down, five here for the Chucks. Miller in motion, and now it's the Zeke up the middle, and he is met and runs right over one of the Bulldogs. Yeah. That was Rylan Rupp, and then Zeke's going to be about 2 yards short as he's marked down at the 36-yard line. Call it third down and two here for Punxsutawney as they continue to move this football.
Yeah, I think just hand off to Martz out of the backfield right now.
Martz up the middle, and there's a flag that's going to be a penalty
be
on the Chucks.
Yep,
as Martz did have the first down, but that'll be no plays. I think we had a couple guys moving at the same time, so can't do that in American football. Back him up 5 yards. Ball now at the 41-yard line, makes it third down and six.
Martz is hitting that hole nicely. And that would have been another 5 yard gain right there.
Moore again under center in motion. Now it's Miller up the middle, and he is met immediately. Nice play there by number 50 of the Bulldogs. Caden Adams got a 1 yard gain. It's going to bring up fourth down. And a long five here for the Chucks. Ball at the 40, and it looks like Punxsutawney's going to punt.
Yeah, you know, I would have liked to have seen Punxsutawney gain three on that anyway, making a manageable fourth down. Now, Hetrick's been getting nice hang time and hitting good high spirals on the punts, but this is a case where I would be trying to kick to the sideline. Try to coffin it down there somewhere near the end zone, but away from the...
Hetrick stands just inside his 50. Nice kick. This one is angled.
That is very nice.
That ball will go out inside the five,
punt.
I believe. We'll see where they mark. At the 5-yard line. Great punt by Peyton Hetrick. And with 5:52 to go here in the first quarter, brought to you by Punxsutawney Shop and Save, we will see Red Bank's offense for the first time as they lead 7-0 after a punt return on their first possession.
Well, Punxsutawney was able to move the ball that drive with their running game, just stalled on the penalty. But this is going to be big right here. We've got to come out. We've got to send a message on this first offensive drive for the Bulldogs.
Cam Wagner will go shotgun. He'll have three to the far side, one near side. It's a handoff up the middle. That is to Drew Byers, and he is going to go nowhere.
Yeah.
They're going to go.
They give him the line of scrimmage.
They're going to give him the line of scrimmage, but then he end up being tackled about the two, but it'll be second down 10. Matthew Grusky with the tackle for the Chucks. Same formation, three to the far side for Wagner. Wagner, he'll roll out that way, looks down the field, turns, hits his man in the flat. That is
nice
Tate Minnick, and tackled over there, I believe, Landon Peterson. After a short game, we'll give him maybe three. It's going to bring up third down and seven. Going to bring up third down and seven. This is great opportunity here for the Chucks.
Well, this is a case where I think they need to have a man assigned to Minnick.
And somebody moved, and I believe it's going to be on Punxsutawney. It is. And those penalties, we've had two penalties already in this game, and it's been both Punxsutawney, and this is a free five. Now it makes it a much more manageable third down and about three.
Yeah.
The ball placed at the 13-yard line.
Yeah, those are two mistakes that are very costly. And a lot of times that's the difference between a team that's ranked eighth in the state and a team that's up and coming.
Trips come to this side. They want a new play. Under center goes Wagner, and he's just going to take off, and I think he's going
to
get it.
He got it.
He got to about
16.
The 17-yard line. I think he just saw. I think he actually called that play. I think he saw no nose and just said, "I can go up the middle," and he picks up enough for. Be first and 10, ball at the 18. Wagner hands off again. This is to Byers, and he will go nowhere.
Byers
and, there's a penalty flag coming out way out. Let's see what we're going to have here. It's going to be some personal foul, I'm sure, but, boy, the official from this side, he fired it in there. And let's see what they're going to call. As it's going to be base, maybe a yard gain for Byers. It's going to be second and 9, but we're going to see what we're going to run into here. As the official on this side, he just threw a flag. It's a personal foul. It's going to be on Redbank.
On Redbank. Well, there was a hard tackle there. There was a good hard tackle by Punxsy. And then I think somebody took offense to that.
So that's going to back them up, make it a first down and 20. As Wagner, again from the shotgun, sidecar, back to pass. Has plenty of time. Hits his man, Minnick. Minnick bounces around the middle. Still hasn't gone down. Now he gets to the far side. He's got Miller is going to get him out of there. Justin Miller will get him out of bounds. But, wow, he just kind of danced around in the middle of the field, and nobody could catch him. Justin Miller finally pushes him out, but not before he gets up to the 34-yard line. So a big first down, 24 yards. Or excuse me, 17 yards, Eric, sorry. Wagner hands off to Byers. Byers up the middle, and he is brought down immediately. That's.
Now, you were right.
Griffin Berry with a big hit there.
The ball had been moved back to the 9.
Okay, yep. 1 yard gain, second down, and 9 for the Bulldogs. 4:18 to go in here. Punxsy shop and save. First quarter. Wagner gets out of there, has time, now has to bring it down, and he's got room on the far side. He's got the first down, stays in bounds, and is brought down by Justin Miller and I believe Mason Nesbitt. Not before they pick up a first down. Ball at the 48-yard line, first and 10. 13-yard gain. And boy, the numbers are, folks, I'll be honest, the numbers are tough to see with these camo jerseys. They got blue letters, so it's a little bit difficult. So it may take us a moment to pick up who's making those plays. Wagner being chased around. Oh, just escaping and then hitting a guy wide open. That's Aiden Ortz, and he'll have a first down to the 30. Noah Weaver and Zach Presloyd making tackle there. But again, another big play for the Bulldogs, first and 10 at the Chucks 30. Clock running at 3:29 here in the first quarter. Redbank leading 7-0 and on the move again. Wagner has twins to each side. Again, he has lone receiver or setback. That's Drew Byers to his left. Has plenty of time. Looks deep, and this one could be picked off, and I believe it's incomplete. Peyton Hetrick, he was actually the better receiver on that play, it looked like. And it looked like Mason Klaus did a nice job as actually
just kind of running through him. Yeah, I mean, not offensive interference or anything. He just ran through him when Peyton got his hands on the ball.
So second and 10 from the 30 of the Chucks for the Bulldogs. Again, same formation, Wagner in the shotgun.
Boy, does he throw a pretty ball.
He hits a man across the middle. That is Minnick. Minnick has a first down and more all the way down near the 10. He's going to be out of bounds. It looks to be at the 13-yard line. 17 yards on that pass and catch. Just a little pass across the middle, and he was wide open. And these guys can make some moves once they get the ball.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, you got to cover them tough at the line. And as far as the quarterback goes, I just assign a linebacker to him and hold him there.
Wagner hits Byers in the backfield, and he's going to be dropped for no gain, second down 10.
Number 77 had a great big handful of jersey there.
2:40 on the running clock in this first quarter. Brought to you by Punxsy Shop and Save. Again, the Chucks trail 7-0. Red Bank on the move. Second and 10 at the Punxsy 13. Wagner again, shotgun. Looks far side, has it across the middle.
Oh,
hits
my.
A man, that's Mason Klaus. And he's inside the 5 to the 3. And it's going to be close to a first down. We'll see where they mark it. It's going to be just short, so it's a 9-yard gain. Ball at the 4. Third down and 1. You know, we had a good angle on that, Eric. He threw that ball when he wasn't even open. He just
right.
threw it in an area, and
yeah.
Klaus got to it.
Yeah, that is, I mean, this is a very high-level offense they're running.
Twin receivers to the far side. Two in the backfield. Bowers. And he is going to get nothing. And there's a penalty marker down, too. We're going to see what this is going to be. But nevertheless, it's going to be stuffed. I think he's going to lose 2 back to the 6. So
that was
Grusky
on the.
It's going to be a hold, I believe, on Red Bank. So we'll see what the Chucks want to do.
Well, the one lineman out here has been getting, I mean, he's had a handful of jersey on every play.
It is going to be a hold, and the Chucks will accept it. They'll back him up to the 14.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you have a better chance of stopping this back here than, I mean, they were going for it where they were.
So the ball's at the 14, third down, 11 to go. This will be a big stop for the Chucks here. You're obviously going to go two down territory here for Red Bank. Minnick on the little pitch. He tries to turn the corner, and that is Anthony Gould, the first man there, and then he got some help by Vogel and I believe Peterson. But Anthony Gould making a play there. Another loss of 5 back to the 19. Great job by the BN.
Who was that on the carry?
That was number 5.
That was Minnick. Boy, they're doing a good job defending the run. Gould's been doing a nice job when he's got some playing time.
Trips to this side. Fourth down and 15. Wagner has to roll out. He has room up the middle. He's on the move, and he dives in, and it's a
first
short.
Down.
Let's see where they mark him. I think he might be short.
They're marking him, it looks like, the 4-yard line.
I think
line.
He's going to be a yard short. And it is a turnover on downs as Wagner got to the 4, needed to get to the 3, and the Chucks get a turnover on downs with 1:07 to go. First corner. Big stop for Punxsy, trailing 7-0.
Right. They need to get the ball out of their end, though. This happened last week up in Kane. We did the same thing. And then immediately had a fumble on the next play. And
so Punxsy, first and 10 at their 4.
With this running game, I would play it real safe and just.
Twin receivers this side. More from the shotgun. He's going to hand off to Zeke. Zeke is going to lose a yard to the 3 as everybody from Red Bank came up and was looking for that play. Second down and 11
This
for the Chucks.
This is a situation, I just go to the bigger back. I go to Martz, get a yard, 2 yards, just a little bit of breathing room.
Second and 11. Miller will be that H-back. Sidecar is Zeke to the right of Seth Moore. Moore, he'll hand it out, try to get Zeke to the outside. He'll break a couple
nice.
Tackles and then gets to the 9. Boy, he almost broke that.
Yeah, that was
for a big gain, but he does get to the 9-yard line.
So 6-yard gain, but that was a hard-fought 6 yards.
Making it third down and about a long 5.
That was real good individual effort.
Martz back in the backfield.
I think Punxsy might be taking a timeout.
And Punxsy will take it as the quarter ends, actually.
Oh,
so
let the quarter
that'll do
out.
It for the first quarter of action. Chucks trail Red Bank 7-0. We'll take a 1-minute break. You're listening to a Laurel Eye Clinic Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy.
This is Tim Cronin-Letter, CEO of InFirst Bank. Here at InFirst Bank, we are celebrating our 100-year anniversary. May I introduce you to one of our over 100 amazing InFirst team members working for you.
Hello, this is Misty Wilson, Customer Support Center Manager. I have been working for InFirst Bank for 16 years, and I couldn't imagine being anywhere else. I love being part of the InFirst Bank team because we are always striving to help our customers and our community.
Hello, this is Lisa Fitzgerald, Operations Representative with InFirst Bank. What I love about working at InFirst is being part of a dedicated team who treat customers and coworkers like family. Being a hometown bank, we are invested in the growth of our community and would like to thank those who are already a part of our family and invite others to join us for many years to come.
Thank you, thank you for you, 1922.
Vision Creative Solutions is a full-service marketing company that assists small and mid-sized companies with a wide range of marketing services. Our services include the creation, design of logos, brand development, stationery items, marketing, website development, and design redesign, search engine optimization, web hosting, advertising, direct mail, newsletters, e-blasts, branded apparel, promotional items,
Z-cloth.
Public relations, marketing planning,
lose a yard or so.
Yeah, lost a yard or so.
All types of printing and much more. That's Vision Creative Solutions. Call them at 938-5864. That's 938-5864.
I'd be coming hard on this one if I were them.
The Punxsy Chucks play here. FM 100.9 at AM 1540.
Nice punt.
Punxsutawney.
Welcome back as we get set to start the second quarter.
Second quarter started, DJ.
Zeke Bennett on a run lost a yard, so it was fourth down. The Chucks had to punt, and Peyton Hetrick did a great job of getting to the other side of the 50. So Redbank will start first and 10 at their 48-yard line. So nice job there by Peyton Hetrick.
Yeah, we couldn't ask for much better in that situation.
Second quarter brought to you by Big Run Flooring. Again, Redbank leading 7-0 as they are now going right to left on your radio dial. Wagner will hand off to Byers. Byers will get to the 50, and that is it. This Chucks interior line doing a great job. That was Grusky and Martz in on that tackle. Second down, 8. Wagner again, shotgun. I'm sure he runs shotgun pretty much the whole time.
Yeah.
Back to pass, looks this way. Got a man deep.
Another gold.
And it is caught and into the end zone for a 50-yard touchdown. That is to Aiden Ortz, who was just left wide open down the middle. And a perfect pass by
Pass by Wagner.
13-0, 10:36 to go, second quarter.
when you're past the lineman, he's not between you and the quarterback anymore, but you can no longer move forward, but your arms are up.
So a 50-yard strike. Beautiful, beautiful ball. Wagner to Ortz, and they will be going for the extra point here. 10:36 to go, second quarter.
Ortz is the receiver I saw during warm-ups. Just nice hands.
Owen Klaus is up, and that
out
to be good. Yep, it does catch off the right side. 14-0. Take a 30-second break. You're listening to a Lowell Eye Clinic Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy.
Stump Creek Auto Sales on 119 in Stump Creek near Punxsutawney, where inventory is always fresh and always new. Looking for a Jeep or a truck? We got what you need. We also buy cars, too. Call Adam at 814-427-6116. Open Monday through Friday, 8 to 4. Evenings and weekends by appointment. Closed on Sundays. Like Stump Creek Auto Sales on Facebook. Have a great season, Chucks. We're rooting for you.
Welcome back. to the Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive. The Red Bank gets on the board again. A 50-yard touchdown pass. Wagner to Orts. Extra point was good. Red Bank leading 14-0 here, 10:36 to go, second quarter. That was your Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. Klaus kickoff, line drive kick. This will be picked up by Zeke at the 10. He'll get up near the 30, bounces around, gets across the 30, and up to on his feet.
There's a flag down.
Actually, I'm trying to think. That was actually Griffin White, Griffin White with a nice run.
That was a nice return.
Up to the 35, but there's a penalty marker
down. Yeah, penalty marker down, and it was thrown early.
Good chance of a hold on the Chucks.
Yep.
And it will be, so that'll back them up to the 25, I believe.
26-yard line.
Call it the 26, first and 10 for the Chucks. And, Eric, this is a we've said this every time. This is an important possession. This really is.
Yeah, I mean,
continue to move the football. Just continue.
Yeah, continue to move the football. It's 14-0. I mean, this game is not out of line by any means.
Twins to each side for Seth Moore in a shotgun. He's got Zeke Bennett to his right. Hand off to Bennett. He'll lead up through and finally gets a nice run up
across
the 30 to the 33-yard line. 6 yards, being up second down four. Actually, 7 yards.
7 yards, yep.
Second down and three. Quickly up. Chuck, same formation. They'll run Zeke this way. And he'll get a first down as he gets enough. He gets about 4 yards. Up across the 35, up to the 38-yard line. First and 10 for Punxsy. Zeke going to get a breather, and Griffin White will check in. This is the time where it's getting hard to see those numbers, Eric.
It's real hard.
Dusk. The lights aren't quite on enough yet.
Oh, I thought you meant just at our age.
Yeah, well, that too. In motion is Peterson to the far side. He'll join Noah Weaver over there as Seth is under center. He'll hand off to Griffin White. Griffin White breaks a tackle. He gets across to 40 to 41. Nice hard run for Griffin. Nice to see him back.
White.
Second down, 7. 9:24 on a running clock here in the second quarter, brought to you by Big Run Flooring. Chucks trail 14-0. Got the football. They're on the move. Second down, 7 from their 41. More from the shotgun. Looks this way. Quick hitter. It's to Zach Presloyd, and he's hit immediately by Mason Klaus. Give him a couple yards up to the 44. It's going to bring up third down six, or third down and four. Chucks will go twins each side. Zeke checks back in. He's to the right of the shotgun quarterback, Seth Moore. He'll hand off to Zeke. Zeke gets up there, and he will be about a yard short. Interesting call here coming up for the Chucks. It'll be fourth and one. As again, he is met there by number 50, Caden Adams. And the Chucks will go for it here, fourth and one at their own 47-yard line. Need to get about a half a yard. Seth Moore will keep it.
Yeah.
He'll get it.
Yep.
He got his yard and a half. And it's a first and 10 for the Chucks. Nice job there by Seth. Nice job by that offensive line led by Vogel, who's the center, just kind of got a little push. Ball placed at the 49-yard line of Punxsy. Clock starting at 8:07 here in the second quarter. Two in the backfield now. It's going to be Justin Miller. And he'll rip up through for about 4 or 5 yards.
Yeah.
Give him 5 to the 46 of Red Bank. Second down 5 for the Chucks. Using the bigger backs a little bit more,
well,
and that's getting
that's the kind of running they need to do with Miller. They've been running kind of sweeps and stuff with him. Just let him tuck the ball and run up the middle. He's a powerful kid.
Zeke up the middle. He's going to be a couple yards short. As they'll mark him at the 43-yard line. Third down 2. Punxsy, a little bit of pick up this series, hurrying up a little bit, getting things moving.
Yep, these guys have done a nice job.
Twin receivers to this side. The lone receiver to the far side is Weaver. Sash shotgun. He'll hit Justin Miller, and he's going to be about to get back to the line of scrimmage, bring up fourth down and two. Nice job there by, I believe that was Adams again for Redbank. Now we're going to bring in Nesbitt and Martz, bringing in a little bit bigger back with Zeke. So they'll go with that double wing look with Miller and Zeke at the wings and Martz in the backfield. It's going to be Zeke, and he's going to get it as he leads up two. He breaks another tackle and down inside the 35. So he's brought down by Mason Klaus, but not until he gets to the 33-yard line, 10-yard run. Big pickup. That was a double lead. They took Miller and Martz in through that hole and opened it up for Bennett.
Yeah, that was a nice run.
Same formation. Now Zeke comes out wide, out the pass, looking for Noah Weaver on the far side. He's got a step, and what a nice play. Good pass, but nice coverage by Tate Minnick.
Beautiful coverage.
I mean,
he got the hand on the ball.
Yep. Actually, Noah was actually about a step ahead, and that pass was there, and Minnick made up that step and got a hand in there. It was a very nice coverage.
I'll tell you what, I'm really impressed by these guys playing on the outside.
6:16 to go, second quarter, brought to you by Big Run Flooring. Chucks trail 14-0. They have it second and 10 at Red Banks 33. Miller up the middle, and he's upended.
Nice gain.
By Mason Klaus upended there. It gets about 5 or 6 yards. Inside the 30, we'll call it the 28. So third down and 5 for the Chucks. More under center. Zeke in motion. Up the middle to Martz. Martz, he's going to be close. I think
he has it.
Needed 5. I think he got it.
I think he got it.
As he gets inside the 25 to the 23, give him 5 yards and a Chucks first down. Landon Martz having a nice first half here in the run game.
Yeah. Yeah, he has 4 carries for 20 yards, and they've been 5 apiece.
First and 10 for the Punxsutawney, ball at the 23. Same formation, the double wing with Martz in the backfield. Now Bennett comes wide this way. Martz again tries to get it outside. He has some room. He turns the corner and nice job.
Nice tackle by Kale.
Ashton Kale catching Martz, but Martz gets to the 15. Looks like they'll mark the 16, so a nice
8-yard gain.
Yeah, 8 yards for Martz. Second down, 2. Showing his burst of speed from the outside, but Kale did a nice job of catching.
These guys are fast.
Same formation, more. He'll get Zeke to the far side, and he has room, cuts it up, breaks a tackle, breaks another one inside the 5. As that is Caden Adams that brings him down, but it's first and goal for the Chucks.
About a 10-yard gain for Zeke.
We'll call it the 4, first and goal from the
yards.
4. This is the 16th play of this drive, 4:25 to go second quarter. In motion, it's Justin Miller. Brings it around, and he is brought down for no gain. Second and goal.
I'd like to see Miller turn it upfield a little quicker when they get these sweeps.
They'll mark the ball at the 3, so we'll give him 1 yard, second down and goal from the 3. Chuck's trying to punch this in. They trail by 14 here in the second quarter. Under center's Moore. In motion is Zeke. Zeke up the middle, double lead. He's going to be into the end zone. He's going to be just short, I think. Yep, they're going to get it to him. 3 yards, Zeke Bennett. The Chucks get on the board with 3:47 to go. Here in this second quarter, nice hard running by the Chucks all the way down the field, starting out at their 26.
That is a beautiful drive. They took that one shot, and Moore threw a beautiful pass. It was just well defended, but that is exactly the kind of drive Punxsutawney needs.
Going to go for the extra point here with Peyton Hetrick. Zeke Bennett holding. Kick is up and right down the middle. 14-7. Chucks get on the board. Get within seven. 3:47 to go. We'll take a 30-second break. You're listening to a Laurel Eye Clinic Jefferson County High School Sports Night. Fox Sports Punxsutawney.
Locally owned CRW Home Center on Martha Street, Punxsutawney, has helped build the community since 1989, always providing customers with the highest quality products and services at competitive prices. Everyone at CRW Home Center is wishing the Chucks football team the best of luck this year. Go Chucks!
Have you checked Jenny Mart out yet? Jenny Mart has a variety of gently used and new items, including baby items, clothing, household items, and more. Jenny Mart is on Central Street in Rossier beside the Rossier Post Office. Open Monday through Friday, 10 to 5, Saturday 9 to 1.
Welcome back. The Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. The Chucks on the board starting at their 26-yard line, 17-play drive. Zeke Bennett punches it in from 3 yards out. Extra point by Peyton Hetrick was good. 14-7, the Chucks trailing Redbank with 3:47 to go here in this second quarter. Don't forget to stay tuned for our halftime show brought to you by CRW Home Center. We'll have some rundown of the first half scoring along with some stats from Eric, who does an excellent job, Eric, on the stats. Like I read them, they must go by your stats because they're telling us. That,
oh, yeah? Well, I mean, whatever. Now, that drive right there, DJ, was something we've talked about. We had a big dose of Miller, a big dose of Martz, and given Zeke a rest.
Hetrick, a little quick kick. This, I like these, and just falling on it, that was, I believe, yeah, that is number 13, Cole Bish. And they'll get it over at the 32. I like that kind of a kick.
Yep, that's okay because, I mean, kicks around in there. I don't mind the pooch kicks, squib kicks. I like all that stuff, especially in this game. Keep it out of the guys that can return its hands.
Ball spot at the 33-yard line, first and 10, 3:46 to go. Cam Wagner from the shotgun, twins to each side. Again, it's Byers to his right. He'll take the handoff. Finds a couple yards up the middle. Again, nice stop by the Chucks interior line. That was Ryan Knopf. Or excuse me, that was Griffin Barrick, number 73, with that stop. Give him 3 yards to the 36-yard line. Wagner chased around, finds some room, has to get out of there. Being chased by Nesbitt, he will be just short. Mason Nesbitt chasing him out there.
Going to have about a 6 yard, 7 yard run.
It's going to be found third and short. Third and two. As boy, they're letting a little bit go on back there, Eric. I'm kind of falling to play, so I don't get to see it all. But
yeah, well,
trips to the side. Wagner rolling this way, looks across the middle, tipped and intercepted by Justin Miller. He's on his way to the far side, and he's brought down back out the line of scrimmage.
Beautiful.
That ball's tipped in the middle. Justin Miller picks it up, and it's a turnover for the Chucks with 3:03 to go. Trailing by 7 and a lot of time here. They got all 3 timeouts as well.
Yeah, they've got all 3 timeouts. This defense just went off the field after a 17-play drive, and now they're coming right back on.
So Punxsutawney in Redbank territory at the 42-yard line with 3:03 to go. I believe that was Martz. That was Justin Miller who's getting work after the interception. He'll pick up about 4 yards, make it second down and 6. Ball at the 37, almost 5 actually.
Yeah, we're calling it 5. I'm the stats guy.
That's right, dude. You're on. More under center.
Oh,
ball goes down, and I believe Seth got it back. Nope, Redbank got it, I believe. and I believe it was number 81 who come up with that, Colton Schick. So just like that, the Chucks turn it over. Another snap, and they just got Seth out of the way, which is what you do. They got the quarterback out of the way, and somebody else fell on it. So,
well, that's something that Punxsutawney really needs to clean up. We saw it several times last week and twice already in this game.
So Redbank gets it back at their 37-yard line.
With plenty of time left.
So that interception... as this is Byers, and again, a nice job by this interior line.
He lost the yard.
Anthony Gould again on that defensive end, making a nice stop, loss of one.
He's become a good, solid tackler.
Yeah, he does.
A consistent, solid tackler.
Trips go to the far side. Clock running under 2 minutes to go here in the second quarter, brought to you by Big Run Flooring. Wagner from the shotgun, three to the far side. Looks this way. Brings it down. Now it works.
Ball is tipped
again.
Tipped ball.
I'm not sure who's getting a hand on that. I might have been Griffin Barrick. It's going to bring up third down and 11. Clock stopped at 1:49. I'll tell you what I'm seeing is the D-backs and so forth are doing a great job of covering, and Wagner can't hit that first read. He's looking off because he can't find the first guy. Wagner back, straight up, now rolls out.
Oh, man.
Looking far side. Has a man, and it is caught right at the sticks. Ashton Kale, we're going to see where they spot it. It may be just short.
We'll
the spot. It's going to be fourth. That we're going to measure, I believe. Nope, they're going to say first down.
That was a 12-yard play then.
First and 10, ball at the 47-yard line. Clock stopped at 1:42.
Well, these guys only need one play to score. I mean, and that's why it's so important to get them off the field.
Trips come to this side now for the Bulldogs. Wagner again, shotgun, where he's been all night. Steps up, has a man far side. Again, that is Kale again. He's going to be about a yard short, brought down over there by Martz. Second down and one after a 9-yard gain. Timeout on the field, I believe taken by Redbank. 1:31 to go. We'll go ahead and stay there. And Eric, what an entertaining game.
Yeah, it is a very entertaining game so far, but Punxsutawney needs to clean up the mistakes. Penalties have hurt us, and we had momentum firmly on our side going into that drive after the interception. We've had some faulty snaps the last 2 weeks between faulty exchanges.
So each team has a turnover, interception by the Chucks, Justin Miller, and then a fumble recovery by the Bulldogs, all in this last 3 minutes of
yeah,
this half.
So all within the last minute and a half, actually.
Yes, of clock time, yes. So second down and one for Redbank. Ball placed at the Chucks 44-yard line. They do lead our Punxsutawney Chucks 14-7. Continue to run to three wide on this side, one to the lone side. That's Kale over there by himself. Wagner looks that way, now down the middle, and he finds Kale again on a nice out pattern. Pushed out of bounds by Peterson, but it's enough for a first down, and the clock stops.
Yeah.
Ball is going to be spotted. Looks to be about the 33-yard line, first and 10.
Yeah, when you let him set and throw to that first man he wants, he's a very good passer.
Back to pass again. Now looks towards the trip side. Now looks around. Now has nowhere to go. Just takes off. He has room down the far side and then gets out of bounds.
About a 13-yard run.
And down near the 20, call it the 21-yard line, it looks. First and 10, clock stopped at 1:21.
If Punxsutawney can get out of this 14-7, get out of this half at 14-7.
Wagner looks again this way. Now across the middle, and it's picked off!
That is Landon Martz. Landon Martz has got that ball. He's going to chase out. And he goes right at Wagner. We talked about him not taking away from the hits. And Landon Martz gets that ball up across the 50 into Chuck's territory. And boy, is Landon Martz having the first half. Two interceptions this game for the Chucks. Justin Miller and now Landon Martz. And Martz gets it all the way to the 49-yard line of Redbank. 109 to go. Punxsutawney has all three timeouts.
Jeez.
Double snap, and Seth had to go down to a knee again.
Yeah, we can't blame Moore for that. I mean, the ball.
And he's going to lose about 4 yards.
He fielded that like a ground ball.
Back to Punxsutawney's 47-yard line, and Punxsutawney will take a timeout. Again, we'll stay here. 107 to go, setting the stage for you here left in the second quarter. Brought to you by Big Run Flooring. Punxsutawney trailing 14-7. Big interception by Landon Martz.
Huge interception.
Probably about a 30-yard return or so.
Oh, more than that. They had the ball inside the 20.
Okay.
They had the ball to 21.
Yeah, so he got that about the 15 or so.
Yeah, 35-yard return probably.
Yep, got that ball inside the 50 of Redbank territory. And then our first snap, bad snap, rolled back to Seth. He was on a knee, and he's going to be down at the 47.5-yard line of the Chucks, where they'll have second down and 13. Timeout's over. Chucks will go with three to the far side. Zeke Bennett to the right of Seth Moore, who's in the shotgun. Noah Weaver, the lone receiver. Nope, he's going to be joined now by Peterson. This is Presloyd and Peterson to this side. Moore looks over that way as he hits his receiver. That's Noah Weaver. And Weaver's going to get about 5 yards, making it third down and 8. Clock continue to run at 55 seconds here. Ball marked at the 47-yard line of the Bulldogs.
I would not mind seeing them take a shot downfield.
Hands off to Zeke. Zeke is going to be stopped short as he crossed the 45 to the 44. Now a timeout's taken. It's going to bring up third down and 5. Fourth down and 5. And Punxsutawney takes their second timeout with 41 seconds remaining.
I don't really understand the timeout here. I mean, I think you're in a position on the field, in a position in the quarter or the half. Yeah, just punt the ball, try to get it out of bounds downward, somewhere inside the 20.
See, looks like we're going to go with a punt here.
And keep the momentum. See, I would have rather just seen the clock run if we're going to end up punting the ball anyway.
Although, let's see what we're going to do here. We're not going to punt. Seth Moore's still out on the field, so we're going for it here. Big call here for the Chucks offense. Fourth down, 5.
I was going to say maybe this would have been a good time for a fake, because we know Hector can throw the ball.
Ball out there, 44-yard line of Redbank. Moore from the shotgun. Looks this way, rolls out, has time, has a man, and it is in. Great coverage there. Boy, Landon Peterson was open, but man.
Kale
again with just great coverage, knocks that ball out. And it's
has that closing speed.
And with 36 seconds remaining, Red Bank will take over, leading 14-7 here in the half. It's been an entertaining 3 minutes of football.
Yeah.
Eric, want to take a quick chance to give a shout-out. Told you Colston was over in Indiana. He was playing fall ball, and they're listening right now. So I want to say hello to Colston and his buddy CBD while listening to the game right now on Fox Sports Punxsutawney. So, guys, good job today. Hope you enjoyed it. Beautiful day for baseball. So have a good night, and good job. So Punxsutawney will take another timeout. We'll stay here.
Well, I'll tell you what.
36 seconds remaining.
We've seen the arm Wagner has and the talent of these receivers. I almost think you have Weaver or Hetrick back there playing center field. Just defend the pass, make the tackle inbounds, because I believe Redbank has all three timeouts.
Nah, they used one. Yeah, they have two remaining. Again, make sure you stay tuned to our halftime show brought to you by CRW Home Center. Wow, it's been an entertaining game. And this place, I'm telling you, this is pretty much standing room only here, Eric. It really is. And you look across, you know, the band of Red Bank is down on the track now, but you look across, it's pretty
fun. Yeah, it's
two people standing
over there,
over
people
there.
Along the fence, yeah.
What a night for football as Red Bank comes out. First and 10 from their 44.
Wagner
has time. Now has to pull it down. Looks. Has a guy. Just floats it up. And that is Orts, who makes a great tackle and then gets out of bounds. A great catch, excuse me. Then gets out of bounds in Punxsy territory right about the 45-yard line. So it's enough for first down. And they got out of bounds with 28 seconds remaining. Trip receivers to this side, two to the far side. Wagner's all by himself in that shotgun in the backfield. Back to pass. Now he's being chased out of there by Grusky. Has time, shoots it.
Oh, my.
But then makes a catch. Mason Krause at the 30. What a catch. He actually slipped. And then the ball was actually thrown low for him.
That was a beautiful reception and a nice hard throw. I thought he was throwing that ball away.
And then Red Bank will take a timeout
with
19 seconds remaining. The ball at the 30-yard line. And, you know, they got a kicker, Owen Klaus. I don't know what he's got. He's looked good on his two extra points.
Yeah, his extra points were making it for the track.
So we'll see what they got here, but 19 seconds left from the 30. Red Bank has some time, and they have another timeout.
Well, Punxsy needs to tighten up the defense here and make the stop inbounds, make them use that timeout.
Yeah, that's a big key. They've had a lot of plays that they're able to just wait and wait and wait, and then somebody coming across the middle is able to be near the edge. They make the catch, and they're able to quickly get out of bounds or pushed out.
Yeah. I mean, when you're the cornerback or safety, I mean, you push them out of bounds. You don't risk missing the tackle.
So Red Bank comes out. They will have one timeout remaining. 19 seconds remaining. They're at the Chucks 30. They do lead Punxsy 14-7 here in this second quarter, brought to you by Big Run Flooring. Trips to the far side this time. Twins this way for Wagner. He'll look that way. Pulls it down, rolls out of there. Being chased down. Grusky. Oh! And now Wagner has time and
gets out of bounds.
7 or 8 yards and gets out of bounds with 10 seconds remaining. Grusky and, again, Anthony Gould on the chase, and Grusky dove over there, almost got an ankle. Give him about 7 on that run. It's second down 3, but more importantly, it's 10 seconds remaining.
The last time I saw Grusky run on this field like that was about, what, 47 years ago?
Yeah. Ball's at the 23-yard line. Second down 3. Wagner with trips to this side, looks this way, has to pull it down. Here comes Grusky again. And now Wagner just looking, and he'll stop, and I think time's going to run out.
I think so.
It will. He gets inside the 10, and he's slow to get up. As he is slow to get up. I think time is up. I don't think, and there's a flag. Well, now, wait a minute. We have a flag, so that hold everything. The ball would be inside the 10 as they're looking at Wagner. Joel Bowers, the trainer, taking a look. And he gets over there. We're going to see what the penalty is. We still may have one more play left if it's on the defense. Ball's at the 8. So it's about a 14-yard run for Wagner. So with a timeout remaining, I'm going to say Red Bank's probably going to use it here. Let's all sort everything out. We're still waiting to see what the play is. No flag. And I think that'll do it for the half.
I think
that will do it for the half.
I think it was a hard hit. there was a hard hit, but not an illegal hit. I mean, I think that's the right call. I don't think it was helmet to helmet. I think it was shoulder to helmet on a quarterback that was trying to gain yards.
So what an entertaining first half of football here from Jack LaMarcus Stadium. The Chucks trail 14-7 to Redbank, but it's been entertaining. The last 3 minutes have been real entertaining. The Chucks make another stop, and we'll go into the half trailing by 7, 14-7. We'll take a two-minute break. When we come back, we'll have our CRW Home Center halftime show. You're listening to a Lorelei Clinic Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsutawney.
What time is it?
It's 8 o'clock, honey. Get up. You're going to be late for work.
What? It's still dark out. Hold on. That's not an 8, dear. That's a 5. It's 5 o'clock. You've not been able to see when you first wake up. You know, you should really get a LASIK consultation from our eye clinic.
What? It can't be. Where's my glasses? You're wrong.
I love you, dear, but no, I'm not. Before I go back to bed, save Laurel Eye Clinic's number in your phone, would you? 1-800-494-2020. And you may want to bookmark their website, too. LaurelEye.com.
Ooh, honey, look. It says that LASIK consultations are free. I'm going to call them today. Honey?
Call the Laurel Eye Clinic today at 1-800-494-2020 or visit LaurelEye.com to learn more about what LASIK and Laurel Eye can do for you, as well as our fantastic 24-month no-interest financing option through Care Credit. And why Laurel Eye? Because it's your eyes. The Laurel Eye Clinic, a better vision for you.
The Punxsutawney Area Hospital has some big news on some recent recognition. Here's Katie Donald, Recruitment and Public Relations Specialist at Punxsutawney Area Hospital, with the news.
Punxsutawney Area Hospital is proud to announce the recent accomplishment of being named a top 20 rural community hospital in the U.S., named by the National Rural Health Association. The Punxsutawney Area Hospital scored higher than all of the other rural and community hospitals in the state of Pennsylvania in the following areas: inpatient market share, outpatient market share, quality outcomes, patient perspective, cost, charge, and financial efficiency. Congratulations to the hardworking staff, and thank you for your continued dedication to the Punxsutawney community. Punxsutawney Area Hospital, where patients come first, providing care for more than 130 years, a proud past and a strong future.
We know do-it-yourself. Napa Midtown Auto Parts, your locally owned and operated Napa store. We're a proud supporter of local sports, and we're here for professionals, auto enthusiasts, and do-it-yourselfers. Come see us for all your car care needs, and we can custom mix your paint, and we can put your custom mix in aerosol cans. Come see us for details. Napa Midtown Auto Parts. Great people, great products, great Napa know-how. Open 7:30 to 6 p.m. Monday through Friday, Saturday, 8 to 3. Find us, 110 South Gilpin Street, Punxsutawney. Napa Midtown Auto Parts.
Jefferson Machine Company is proud to be a part of our community and is proud to support the Punxsutawney Chucks football team. Jefferson Machine, a leader in heavy equipment repair and replacement, Route 119 in Punxsutawney. Call 938-6420. That's 938-6420. Good luck to the Punxsutawney Chucks from Jefferson Machine Company. Engineering today for a better tomorrow. Jefferson Machine.
Here's the season. Sunglasses. You need to think Gribble Eye Care.
Yeah.
At the Punxsutawney Hospital campus. Gribble Eye Care. Yes, yeah, sunglasses and impressive selection. You bet. Prescription sunglasses and regular glasses and frames too.
They also have Carolina Herrera frames.
Hey, it's important. You wouldn't go without sunscreen. Don't go without eye protection. Just go to Gribble Eye Care.
You know, he's an ophthalmologist, not just an optometrist.
Yeah, that's a big deal.
They also have 9 West and Maui Gym.
John Varvatos, too, show. Gribble Eye Care. Punxsutawney Hospital. You depend on your eyes. Depend on Gribble Eye Care.
Get the XL double deal from Punxsutawney Pizza. 2 16-inch extra-large pizzas with 12 slices covered in pepperoni for only $26.49. The double deal at Punxsutawney Pizza. Call 938-8132. Think about pizza one more time. XL double deal from Punxsutawney Pizza. 2 16-inch extra-large pizzas with 12 slices covered in pepperoni for only $26.49. The XL double deal at Punxsutawney Pizza. Call 938-8132.
Expired 8/31/22. Not valid with any other offer.
This is the home for Punxsutawney Chucks football. FM 100.9 and AM 1540 WECZ. Punxsutawney.
Welcome back to the SRW Home Center
halftime show. DJ Gould, Eric Eddy here with you. What an entertaining first half of football. The Chucks trail 14-7 to Redbank. And, boy, it was a big early start for Redbank because the Chucks had a three and out to start the game. And then on that punt, Mason Klaus went 65 yards on a punt return for the touchdown to get Redbank on the board after the extra point. It was 7-0. Punxsutawney then ran nine plays and punted. Redbank run 13 plays, turned it over and downs to the Chucks at the four. Punxsutawney went three and out and had to punt back with 11:08 to go in the second quarter. Redbank from their 48-yard line, two plays, and they struck a second time. Wagner to Orts for 50 yards on a TD reception. Extra point was good, made it 14-0. Then the Chucks, starting at their 26-yard line, they took 6.5 minutes off the clock, a 17-play drive, and Zeke Bennett brought it in there from 3 yards out. Extra point was good. Punxsutawney made it 14-7. Then Redbank comes back in their next possession, and this is where it got crazy with 3:46 in the game to go in the half. Redbank gets the ball, and it was Justin Miller on a tip ball for the Chucks with an interception. Punxsutawney got it back with 3 minutes remaining, and then on that second play, it was a fumble. Redbank recovered that one, and then
here. Continue to keep us safe on a daily basis. We would like to send a big thank you to all the veterans, active military personnel, and first responders of all types. You are all very brave and we appreciate your sacrifices. Let's have a huge round of applause for our guests of honor here this evening. Thank you.
Band will be playing Amazing Grace. Thank you.
Card on and off when you want. Set spending limits and receive alerts when your card is used. Download the app to your phone, register your card, and you're done. And you can get back to your show, Card Valet, only with Marion Central Bank. Member FDIC.
Medicine shop, the medicine shop, more than just the pharmacy. Serving you since 1990. Overlap services and glasses. Depending on the pharmacy. Personal service. Getting to know you. The mail is in the shop. The mail is in the shop. More than just a pharmacy.
It seems like it took forever for life to get back to normal, but we now can gather together, break bread, go out to dinner, go to old familiar places that make you feel great, and they taste great. Hi, this is Dave Satry of the New Anchor Inn. We still have room for your private parties. We still have adult beverages for a celebration and happy hour. The New Anchor Inn, for 98 years, has had great prices on great homemade food, and it's the same relaxing, comfortable environment that you've grown to know and love. We look forward to serving you at the New Anchor Inn again.
You're listening to Punxsutawney Chuck's Football on Fox Sports, FM 100.9.
Welcome back. Great halftime for you. DJ Gould, Eric Eddy here with you as we get set to start the third quarter of action. Redbank will get the football to start the game. And they lead 14-7. Peyton Hetrick getting set to kick off. Well, we've said it every drive. This is an important one for the Chucks. And they've done well thus far. Hetrick, this little pooch kick.
Ah.
Taken. And I think somebody went a little early on the Chucks part here.
Probably on a kickoff like that. If I was Redbank, I'd just take it.
Ball was kicked, and I think he's down around the 40. We'll see what they want to do. Redbank's gonna make him re-kick, it looks like. Offsides on the Chucks on the kickoff, so now they'll be kicking from the 35. Hetrick will line her back up, right? Puts it right in the middle of the field. Expect that kind of I'm going to expect a little bit more of a kick this time. As we're reset here now from the 35-yard line. Higher kick ball taken at the 25. That is by Kale.
And he got to the 40. Same place.
Yep, got it to about where he was going to start before.
About the 41. They were at the 40 before, so.
Redbank will start this second half with the ball at the 40-yard line, first and 10. Chuck's on the road next week. Next 2 weeks we're away. Go to Central Clarion next week.
Looks as like Wagner was able to shake off whatever.
Yep, Wagner is back there, just checking that. Good
whatever
spot
cobwebs he had.
Motion, he'll pop it to Ortz. Ortz tries to get to the outside, and he's brought down there nice. By the Chucks. Maybe a yard. Landon Marks. Or excuse me, that was Mason Nesbitt that time making the stop. Second down, 9. Wagner will have twins each side. They're going right to left here in this third quarter. Brought to you by Stump Creek Auto. Up the middle, and nothing there.
Nothing.
And that is stuffed. See who's coming out of there. That is going to be Griffin Barrick with a big hit. Loss of 3. It brings up third down, 12. Big stop there for the Chucks. As I'll tell you what, Redbank has not been able to come up the middle in this game. Trips to this side for Wagner. One to the far side, third and 12. Looks back, has time. Going to go deep. And it's caught by Kale. Basically, what you would see in the NFL is a back shoulder pass.
Well, yeah.
And it was well covered. I believe that was Pearson
slipped.
On the coverage. And he just made a nice catch, did Kale, all the way down to the 35-yard line. First and 10. For the Bulldogs.
That's unfortunate because Peterson read that perfectly and he had the break on the ball, but his feet went out from under him.
Same formation, trips to this side. Again, the run. It's up the middle to Byers. He'll get a couple inside the 35. We'll mark it at the 33. Second down and 8. Now we'll go Twins each side. 10-18 running clock here, third quarter. Wagner hits Kale, far side. He breaks a couple tackles and goes down inside the 20. Now they're going to start. He went out of bounds at about the 22. This will be first and 10, 11-yard gain there. And I'm not sure who that was. It just missed tipping that ball.
Yeah, they had it read perfectly. You know, they say the game all the time is a matter of inches. And that was certainly the case there.
Back to pass again, Wagner. He gets the flat. That's Kale again. Oh, makes a man miss. Then he's brought down. I don't know if he got anything, maybe a yard at the most. Nice coverage by the Chucks defense.
They had him pinned. They had him hit for a loss.
That, I believe, Noah Weaver came up on that, helped make that tackle.
Yeah, no gain.
Second down, 10. Ball at the 22 of Punxsy. First series here in this third quarter for Redbank. They lead our Chucks 14-7. Wagner, he'll pitch it to Kale. Kale gets it outside, tries to turn corner. He's got room now and down this near sideline. Turns back in and into the end zone. Did he step out? No, he did not. It's a 22-yard touchdown run for Ashton Kale, as he just danced it down this near sideline and makes it 20-7 with the extra point coming for Redbank with 9:24 to go here in the third.
That was a nice run. He is quick, so when they run that ball to the outside, he's able to get it to the outside before the defense pins him in.
Owen Klaus setting for the extra point. Snap and hold is good, and that kick is right down the middle. 21-7, Redbank out in front, 9:24 to go here in the third quarter. We'll take a 30-second break. You're listening to a Laurel Eichling Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy.
Hi, welcome to Countryside Tire and Repair. I was told you do daily discount specials.
Yes, Monday for police, Tuesday for fire and EMS, Wednesday for women, Thursday for seniors, and Friday for military.
So I'm a veteran that works for county EMS and a woman.
Wow, hat trick. Nice score.
Countryside Tire and Repair. And brakes, oil changes, emergency roadside service, state inspections, U-Haul rentals, and more. At the top of Scotland Avenue, Punxsutawney, and on Facebook.
Welcome back. Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. Redbank Valley, 7 play drive starting at their 40. A 22-yard touchdown run by Ashton Kale. Extra point was good. Redbank leads 21-7 with 9:24 to go here, third quarter. Little pooch kick, and that is going to be caught by Kale. And he still runs. And I think he is going to be down. I don't think he can run it, actually. Let's see where he's down, but boy, they went with a pooch kick on the near side, and Kale come up with it right out of the air. I don't think he can run with it, though. They're going to mark it back at the 47 of Punxsy. Illegal touch.
Yeah, he touched the ball before it went the necessary yard.
Before he got to the 50, so yeah. They're going to call it an illegal touch, so Punxsy will get a break here and start at their 47, first and 10. Boy, that's a break.
The Punxsy coaches were right on that. That was a beautiful play, though.
So Punxsy in good field position. They trail 21-7 here, third quarter. Brought to you by Stump Creek Auto. Seth Moore in the backfield. He's got, now we're going to see the coaches, Redbank coach is still wanting to know.
They need to get him off the field.
As he's trying to get it figured out. Everybody wants to play. Couple officials are talking.
I coached long enough in District 9 to know that I would have got about two steps there before they were throwing a flag.
Now, what's interesting to me, Eric, and I'm glad for Punxsy, but if he touched it early, how are they getting it at the 47? He should be, like,
yeah, they should be on this side. They should be at the,
yeah,
the Redbank 49.
Right.
Is about where he touched it.
But nevertheless, now we're ready to go. Punxsy first and 10 at their 47. Zeke to the right of Seth Moore. He'll take the handoff. Comes back this way and is chased down.
Woo!
There's a flag coming from.
Yeah, horse collar.
They're not going to call it. And it's a no gain, second down 10.
Wow.
They'll give him maybe a yard. We'll give him a yard, second down 9. Boy, that looked like a horse collar to me. I mean, it was right in front. We're right in front of this action.
Yeah, it was right in front of him.
8:50 and a running clock here in the third quarter. Chuck's down by 14, 21-7. Peterson goes in motion to the far side. Miller and Bennett in the backfield. This is Bennett trying to get to the far side, tries to turn it up, and that's Cam. As that Caden Adams, excuse me, he's been all over the place defensively for Redbank. That's that loss of one. It's going to bring up third down and 10. And the Chucks are really having a hard time getting this ball outside.
Well, yeah, I don't know why they are. I don't know why they're bothering. They were doing a great job moving it up the middle with Martz and Miller. And that's when Zeke was getting his bigger hits, 9 and 10-yard gains after that.
Twins each side. It's Weaver and Miller on the far side. Peterson and Presloyd here. Flat pass, and I don't think that was a timed somebody. I think one of the receivers might have went the wrong way because Seth just kind of threw that no man's land. Fortunately, it falls incomplete, making it fourth down and 10, and the Chucks are going to have to punt from their 47.
Yeah, fortunately, Redbank was in man-to-man there, and they stayed with their guys rather than reading the play.
So Kale and Klaus, they got two back now. And a penalty marker, false start on the Chucks.
Okay, they need to reel them in right now. Get them to calm back down and keep their heads in this game.
Back to the 42-yard line. Not a big deal on that penalty, but everybody, again, we just need to calm things down, like you said, Eric. Get back into it. As Hetrick gets set to punt, he'll stand at his 31. Beautiful punt.
Yeah,
taken
right
by Kale at the 25. He'll go up the middle.
Anything that Kale
40 and just tripped up, and now there's a penalty marker down. I believe Anthony Gould again trips him up on that far side. But now we got a penalty marker, and I think this one's going to come back at about the 31-yard line. Got a player down on the far side also. Holding on Redbank, so that's going to back them up. So it's been first and 10, but we do have a player down. It's going to be Kale. Could be just a cramp, possibly.
Yeah, he's been doing a lot of running.
Punxsy forced a punt, but that penalty is going to back Redbank up to the 25-yard line, first and 10.
Well, I'll tell you, when you got a guy that can return it like Kale, I try to punt to the sideline, keep it out of his hands.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. They lead the Chucks 21-7. Wagner in the shotgun. He's got Byers to his left. Trips to the left. One to the far side. Wagner from the shotgun. Back. And it's a fumble on the ground. And I think the Chucks got it.
The Chucks have it.
That ball bounced around. I think Byers ended up getting back on. He did. The ball actually was in one of the Chuck's hands, and then it popped out again, I believe. But that ball goes to 19, so a six-yard loss. Second down, 16. And it looked like Byers got a little bit close to Wagner there, and the ball just kind of hit his hip. Now they'll go trips to the far side, or excuse me, to the near side here, one to the far side, same formation. Quick hitter, and that is incomplete. That was intended for
House. Right there. I mean, this is the rest. I mean, they have to see that.
As Hetrick just went flying. I kind of missed. I was running down
just,
something
the
there.
The receiver just shoved him down from behind after the play.
As it's third down and 16. That was probably the first really errant pass I've seen from Wagner, other than the interceptions. Trips go to the far side. Wagner.
Chop blocks are illegal in high school. This one's
and
coming
it's
back.
Caught. No, it's incomplete, but there's going to be a penalty marker. Flags are flying.
Yeah.
It's getting a little bit chippy out here.
Yeah, and not the way I'd expect.
Punxsy just needs to continue to hold their composure
here. Composure.
That's going to be a big 15-yard penalty coming up.
If these guys are going to play like that, just keep your composure. I don't know what the discussion is.
They're going to take the penalty? No, they're going to decline it because it would have been an incomplete pass, so it's going to bring up fourth down and 16. So it's declined, but it's pretty good. Fourth and 16. The Chucks are going to get the ball back after the punt.
Hey, after that pooch kick on the opening kickoff for the Bulldogs, I would be watching for a fake punt here. Oh, he gets off a boomer.
Bennett back there, and oh!
Yeah, that's going to be 15 yards.
As Bennett was tiled.
My goodness.
I thought he got him early.
Zeke never even got to touch the ball and hit the Bulldog in the back.
Boy, that looked real close.
What Parks needs to do right now is get him. I don't understand what's going on here.
Who ended up with the football?
Punxsy ended up with the football. And
there's a flag.
Yeah, they're calling it on Punxsy. They're gonna call a penalty on Punxsy for talking to the officials.
Let's see what the call is gonna be here. Punxsy has the football. Boy, it looked awful close. That was a great punt.
Great punt. The other thing is, I think if we had replay, you'd see Zeke put his hand up. That would be an interesting thing to ask the coaching staff.
Personal foul. They're going to say he did hit him early, so we're going to re-punt this.
Oh, no, it's going to be ours from the...
Oh, yeah, they're going to take it after. Yeah, it's going to be Punxsy's ball at the 35.
Yeah, and this is what Punxsy needed. Now we need to go back to that short middle running game. Just push the ball, push the ball, push the ball. For whatever reason, these guys are melting down a little bit.
So Punxsy in great position here in this next possession.
This stuff with the coach, this is the second time the coach has been out to the hash marks on his side of the field.
Yeah,
the officials are afraid to throw a flag on number 8 in the state. That's what I believe is happening right now. Nobody wants to hear that, but let Nickel walk out to the hash mark to fight with an official one time and see if the flag comes.
Yeah, it's been interesting here. This has been an interesting third quarter. 6:59 remaining. This third quarter is brought to you by Stump Creek Auto. 21-7 Red Bank, but it doesn't feel like a 14-point lead.
No, it doesn't feel like a 14-point lead, and the way these guys have gotten personal fouls and ones that haven't been called, it seems like it should be the other way. I truthfully believe they thought they were going to come in here and get a 57-7 win and not have any resistance.
Punxsy with the ball at the 35. Now
I
we got
never,
that double wing.
I have never seen a high school game where the coach was allowed to approach the refs to the hash mark two times.
The Punxsy fans are going crazy here. We're in this double wing in motion that's marched up the middle. March is going to get his five as he crawls up near the 30.
Just a big dose of March right now.
In second
middle
down,
the middle.
Second down, five. And now we got a Redbank player down. I think we're starting to hit the cramp sessions.
Well, these guys, I mean, I told you that if they kept playing that, they would get tired. I said that in the first half. Just keep running. Martin Miller up that middle. Make those guys tired. And look what happened in Kane last week. Zeke had two huge runs in the fourth quarter because those guys on the interior were exhausted.
Injury timeout here taken, brought to you by Countryside Tire and Repair. Want to take a moment real quick here to thank all of the sponsors to Chuck's 22. Lenny has told us it's one of the best sponsorships of the season, so we want to thank everybody. Truly appreciate it. Hope you enjoy the coverages, and this has been a heck of a football game here tonight. I mean, Punxsutawney's trailing by 14. But there is a lot of football game left.
There's a lot of football game left, and these guys are cramping. Once the cramps start, they don't stop during the game.
So it'll be second down five once we get this young man taken care of here. And you know, that's one thing. I was just saying this before the game even started. Like, in the first two games, there really hasn't been much cramping by either teams.
No, and that is one thing I'll say. I think the Chucks look fit. Their line hasn't looked tired at the end of the game, and that is a definite credit to the coaches having them ready to play in the heat.
So we're going to come back. Same formation here. Noah Weaver is that lone receiver to the far side. Chuck's going left to right. It's going to be a double wing, Miller and Zeke, with Martz in the backfield. Under center is Moore. Second down, five. This is Martz again. He's going to get three.
He's going to get three or four.
Second or third down and two as he crosses the 30 to about the 27. Clock continuing to run at 6:30 here in this third quarter. Brought to you by Stump Creek Auto. Third and two, same formation for the Chucks. In motion, Zeke. It's Zeke with that double lead, and he will crawl forward. I think he got it.
He's going to get it. They're standing right on the line.
Should be a first down. He needed two and got exactly that, first and 10. I love that double lead because Miller goes, then Martz, and then Zeke. And Redbank's playing it well defensively. It's hard to not get a couple yards out of it.
Right. I mean, this isn't playing for 40 yards at a time.
First and 10, 25. This is Miller trying to get it outside, and he is going to lose 2 yards.
I don't like this trying to get outside. We don't have the speed to run that play outside.
Kale with a nice stop along with Caden Adams.
Redbank's faster than we are. Let's just use our four plays, 2 to 5 yards at a time, up the middle.
Second down, 12, ball at the 27-yard line. Clock running at 5:30 to go here, third quarter.
Give your line a chance to win this game.
Martz in the backfield, lone setback. Back to pass. It is to, that play was set up as Justin Miller did a nice job. And just in and out of the hands of Noah Weaver, that makes it third down 12.
That was a nice little pick. Well, I think truthfully at this spot in the top field, this time of the game,
it's a two.
This is four down territory,
yeah.
So you don't need it all.
Yep. Zeke will come in the backfield. Twins each side. Now Zeke will make it three. Moore has to get rid of it. The ball's on the ground, and that is going to be picked up, I believe, by Redbank. As they were coming around the saw end,
Seth got it back,
so that'll bring up fourth down.
That is a tough play by Seth because he was mauled.
Ball's back to the 32, so loss of five there.
This is where
bringing up fourth down and about 16 or 17.
Punxsutawney doesn't have a boys soccer team this year, and this is where they should have recruited Garrett Bartlebaugh to do some kicking for them. He has the long leg, maybe not as accurate as Hetrick, but
Punxsutawney going for it. They need to get to the 15.
Going nice deep. Pass.
And it is caught, I believe,
by
Noah Weaver. On the far end, it'll be a first down inside the 10.
That was a beautiful, beautiful play.
Lost my breath on that one.
I don't know how Weaver made that catch. That was a perfect throw. And beautiful coverage by Redbank.
Ball's at the 9, first and goal for the Chucks.
Well, now we go. I go right back to that run of the ball in the middle.
Back to the double wing with Martz in the backfield. In motion, Zeke. Give it to Miller. He's got room. Justin Miller.
Touchdown.
9 yards out. Justin Miller gets the Chucks within 8 with 4:25 to go here in the third quarter.
All we have, we stopped them on defense. This is an opportunity our defense needs to stop them.
Patrick getting for the extra point to get it within 7. Snap, hold, and it's right down the middle. We're within 7, 21-14. That take a 30-second break. You're listening to a Laurel Eichling Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy.
Your Punxsy Shop and Save in the Groundhog Plaza wishes the Punxsy football teams, the marching band, the cheerleaders, and support staff all the best this football season. Work hard and have a great time. Good luck from all of us at your Punxsy Shop and Save.
Big Run Flooring knows you have lots of choices. The soft feel of carpet and area rugs on your toes. The easy care of tile, waterproof vinyl, or linoleum. And the warmth of hardwood. Big Run Flooring has the extensive experience, selection, and customer satisfaction at work with your budget.
Wow, this is good.
Big Run Flooring. Check us out on Facebook and our showroom at 300 Main Street, Big Run.
Welcome back. Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. The Chucks starting at the Redbank 35. 8-play drive. Justin Miller from 9 yards out. He takes it into the end zone. The extra point by Peyton Hetrick was good. Chucks climbing back. They trail 21-14. 4:25 to go here in the third quarter. That was your Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary.
That's the run I like to see from Justin Miller. He doesn't possess that speed, I don't believe, to be that sweep runner. But, boy, is he big and strong and can go up the middle.
Hetrick with a kick, and he'll take it deep, and it'll be Kale at the 12. Gets it going forward, goes to the far side, and
nice
job over there. Down about the 25, 26-yard line.
That was good coverage.
With 4:18 to go. See where they mark this. Looks to be about the 27, it looks like.
Yeah, 27-yard line, it looks like, DJ.
Once we get the
That was a beautiful kickoff by Hetrick. And
I didn't see who made the tackle over there. But
I don't know who made the tackle, but they hemmed them in nicely.
Cam Wagner will bring two to each side on the receivers. One to the setback. That's Byers. In motion comes Kale. Or excuse me. That is Minnick, and stopped there by Peterson. And Minnick slow to get up. And I meet Grusky once again, doing a nice job. Give him a yard up to the 28. Second down 9. Clock running at 3:50 here. Third quarter brought to you by Stump Creek Auto. 21-14. Chucks trailing. Redbank with the football. Twins each side for Wagner. He puts in motion. Now it's a handoff, and that is going nowhere. I believe that's Grusky again. Nope, not Grusky. I believe that's Griffin Barrett.
That was Griffin Barrett.
Making a big stop. Loss of about 4. Brings up third down and a 13. Ball back to the 24-yard line.
Okay, you know the pass is coming, secondary.
Trips to the far side.
We've got to keep Wagner hemmed in so he can't run for that first down.
Wagner straight drop. Comes in. Has no misses. Makes a man miss. Martz makes the tackle.
It's going to be close.
I think Martz got him short. He did at the 35. He's going to be 2 yards short. It's going to bring up, it was an 11-yard gain, but Mertz with a shoestring tackle to make it fourth down and a long two, closer to three, and it looks like they're going to punt.
I can't believe they're going to punt.
Tate Minnick's back there. He is the punter. But Zeke's going to
bring it up.
Now he's going to stay back. Yeah, he's going to mid-range.
I look for a direct snap to somebody here. Right here. No.
And it is punted, and Zeke will get it at the 28. Ball getting out of his hand. Now he picks it up, makes a man miss. And now we're going to flag.
There is not a block in the back.
And the ball is out of bounds at the 31, but there's going to be a penalty marker down.
17 got turned around. It was going to be a block in the back.
So Punxsy will take over after this penalty, but Punxsy trailing 21-14, great stop. A three and out they forced to Redbank.
That was a beautiful tackle by Martz.
Just all-out effort, diving and getting it. So ball at the 30, it's going to go back to the 20. Punxsy will have it first and 10 at their 20.
All right.
See if the Chucks can get the move. They're back to that. We're going to build that wing, and Martz is in the backfield. This is that double wing look. This is what's been working for the Chucks. More under center. And I believe that was Martz with the carry.
Did a three-yarder.
Gets up about the 24.
Yeah, about the 24.
Yeah, give him 4 yards.
4 yards. He is,
now give him three, Eric. That's going to mark that 23.
23.
Second down, 7. Minute and 40 to go. Chuck's slowing things down. Plenty of time here. We're just in the third quarter, trailing 21-14. Same formation, more under center. Zeke in motion. There's a Martz again. Martz crawls over the 25, gets it about the 28. He's going to be 2 or 3 yards short. So it'll be third down and give him two. Ball parked at the 28.
Four.
No, yeah. Give him 4, 2 yards to go. Nearing the 1 minute mark here in this third quarter. Same formation. Double lead for Zeke. Here it is, and he is going to be stopped a yard short. I knew that play. I figured that play was coming, but he's going to be a...
What do you do here, DJ?
I think we're going to have to punt away.
I punted away.
No gain, fourth and two, and here comes Peyton Hetrick and the punt team. Probably the best thing here.
Yeah, I think
so. You still got the momentum on your side. And actually, yep, they're going to have to run a play. 4 second difference, so they'll have to get this off. Ball placed at the 28.
What are they? They're taking way too much time here.
Yeah, they're almost going to have to take a timeout.
Yeah, I don't know what they were doing.
They're going to take the delay of game, I think. Yep. You know what, Eric? In a way, I wouldn't have taken the timeout though, because
no.
That you want to save those.
But you knew you were punting. I don't understand the long huddle.
So it'll be a 5 yard penalty.
You know, if
1 second remaining.
If you were up at the 50, you know, a penalty like that makes sense, but
so in a way, they don't have to punt. Now, now we're saying how smart it was because they took the penalty and the clock reruns. So.
Yeah, but you're still deep in your own end.
Yep. Now you got to turn it around and you got to punt from there again. So the quarter will end with the Chucks trailing 21-14. We come back. Punxsy will be punting back to Red Bank. We'll take a 30-second break. You're listening to a Laurel Eichling Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy.
Our team here at Pneumedics Health in Punxsy supports your team, the Chucks. Pneumedics Health wants to help you feel your best. NewMedics advanced procedures can help prevent injury and future pain. Call NewMedics Health today, 814-618-5295, to schedule your initial visit and begin your journey to better well-being. NewMedicsHealth.com and check out their Facebook at NewMedics Health.
Welcome back. DJ Gould and Eric Eddy with you. Start of the fourth quarter. Punxsy will be punting. Trailing 21-14. What an exciting game.
Well, DJ, I might as well say it's an important drive for the Chucks.
Every time you said that, they've been doing it.
That's why I said it.
So Hetrick will be standing at about his 11. Too deep for the Bulldogs.
I'd like to see him rip one off here.
Ooh, got that snap down. End over end.
Hey, that's okay.
And it is fair caught. Nice punt there by Tate Minnick, and he'll start just in Red Bank territory at the 49.
He angled it to the sideline, prevented that return.
So we're in our final quarter of action brought you by NewMedics. First and 10 for the Bulldogs at their 49. Wagner will send three to this side. They're going left to right, the final quarter. Nope, they're going to send two to this side. He's going to actually have a wing in there. It fires in the backfield. Here comes Ortz. Ortz tries to move along and is brought down. He'll get a few, but
nice fight
hanging on. And now there's a cramp on the Chucks, I believe, this time. As see who's coming off there. Mason Nesbitt with the tackle. Give him 2 yards. They do cross into Punxsutawney territory at the 49.
That was a nice tackle, but it was a great effort by Ortz to get two.
Second down, 8 for the Bulldogs. Same formation. This time they get it to Byers, and he is going to go nowhere. As Barrick and Marks in on the stop. Third down and 8. Clock at 11 minutes and running in this final quarter. Chucks trail 21-14. Trying to force a punt for the Bulldogs. Same formation, keeping that wing on the left. Now he looks left, looking deep. And it is in and out of the hands. Knight, great coverage there.
Good
defense. That was Peyton Hetrick.
Yeah, he just waited until he put his hands on the ball and put.
And it's incomplete. And Red Bank's going to have to punt.
That's actually a smart play by Hetrick. He didn't even go for the ball. He just waited. When contact was made with the ball, he pushed him to the turf.
So Minnick will be back to punt. He'll stand at his 38.
Let's see if
Zeke Bennett at
bad
15.
Snap here.
Nope. Good snap. Plenty of time. High. Short punt, but
yeah,
high.
Pay attention, Punxsy. Don't let it hit you.
And it will go out of bounds inside the 20.
Nice job by the Punxsy player over there. Roll out of bounds.
Yep. Noah Weaver, I believe.
That's they talk about football IQ or wrestling IQ or whatever the sport is. That was a high IQ play. He stepped out of bounds when he didn't know where it was at.
Three punts in a row.
Yeah, Punxsy defense is doing a great job.
Punxsy will start at the 18. First and 10. Same formation, Eric. They're going to stick with that double wing look and put Marks in the backfield.
Yeah.
I like the play calling. It slows things down. You're going to get positive yardage. You got three guys that can run the football at any time. Zeke in motion. Marks right up the middle. Marks will get, he'll get one, maybe two. And they'll call it the 19. Second down, 9.
I'd run the same play to Miller right now.
Nearing the 10-15 here to go in this fourth quarter, by brought to you by Pneumatics. Moore. He's going to throw out. He's got a guy, and it is incomplete.
Nice coverage.
And that was intended for Weaver. Nice coverage there by Mason Klaus. I'll tell you one thing, these Redbank Valley defenders, they close quickly.
They close quick, and they're long, lanky guys. They get their hands in there.
I like that play, though. They keep creeping those linebackers up and up and up.
I like to play there, but what I saw was Seth had 15 yards he could have run there. You know what I mean? So rolls out like that again.
Third down 9, Twins deep side now. Seth in the shotgun with Zeke. Now here comes a motion this way. And that was Zach Presloyd on a quick slant, and it's going to bring up fourth down, and the Punxsie will now have to punt.
Moore put some heat on that ball. And with the damp evening like it is here, I'm sure it's getting slick down there.
So Punxsie will now have to punt. So this is four punts in a row, two by each team. This will be the sixth punt in this half. So the defenses have stepped up.
Boy,
it's 21-14, Punxsie trailing, and they're going to be punting back to the Bulldogs. Hetrick, nice ball.
Nice, beautiful
high spiral. And this is Kale. And Kale's going to have a guy to beat. It's Hetrick, and Hetrick will get him down inside.
Right about the one before he touched. That's,
they're going to call it the 2-yard line. But Kale with a huge return. Almost 50 yards on that return. And they will set them up first and 10 at the 2. So first and goal at the 2. Wagner, even with this, with 2 yards to go, they'll go trips to the far side, one this side. Wagner rolls out, looks fine, and it is, ooh! I'm not sure what happened there. It was right in between two defenders, and I think Noah Weaver was the closest player to it. That would have been fun.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd like to see.
.9:38 to go. Clock stopped here in the game. Brought to you by fourth quarter. Brought to you by Pneumatics. After a big punt return, Redbank trying to get this lead extended. It is Minnick, and he is into the end zone. Let's see.
Yeah, he's in.
And it says into the end zone for a 2-yard touchdown, and now it makes it 27-14.
Well, interesting on that punt. Redbank Valley was calling for a fair catch.
Yeah, the
there
other
were
guy
two guys in. Back. Okay, so what's the rule on?
I'm not sure. I was kind of watching that because he was clearly waving his hand, and then
he was standing right beside him waving his hands. So if that's not illegal, then you go down and you hit the guy.
As Redbank player was down there, so quick timeout. He gets off the field. Klaus will now go for the extra point to make this a 14-point lead. 9:34 to go in the game. As Klaus snap holds good, and there's some movement. I think we're going to back him up 5. And they will, so it makes a little bit longer extra point here. And this is a big one. I mean, you know, you make a 13-point game here. Let's see if they get the extra point. Now he's 15. This is a 25-yard attempt now.
He's got plenty of leg for it.
Oh, plenty of leg.
Snap and hold's good, and that is right down the middle as well. 28-14, 9:34 to go. Red Bank out in front of our Chucks. We'll take a 30-second break. You're listening to a Laurel Iclink Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsutawney.
This is Audrey from Punxsutawney's hometown McDonald's wishing the Chucks a great game tonight. Remember, before or after the game, you're always a winner when you download our app for savings and order from your phone. It's good offense. So what's on your mind to tackle after the game? A Big Mac attack, some fries, and a shake? Whatever it is, the Punxsutawney McDonald's team will make it fresh for you and serve it with icy cold drinks. Looking for work? Go online at mchire.com. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
Welcome back. Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. Just a two-play after a big punt return by Minnick. He scores from 2 yards out. Extra point was good. Red Bank now leads 28-14 with 9:34 to go in this fourth quarter. That was your Route 310 Lawn and Garden scoring drive summary. Klaus getting set to kick off. Two deep, actually three deep for the Chucks. And it's a line drive kick, and it's taken by an up guy.
That was a nice job fielding that ball.
I think that might be Peterson. It is Landon Peterson. Nice job. He'll get it to the 40, so Chucks have pretty good field position. Ball at the 40 of Punxsutawney. We're going to go back here with Seth Moore under center. Bennett, the lone setback. I think we're short a guy. And Nesbitt's coming to this side. In motion's Miller. Now he'll stop. Bennett. And there's a penalty marker down. Gets a big run. And it gets across the 50, but there is a marker down. I'm going to say somebody might have moved a little early, Eric.
Yeah, that's what it's looking like.
Personal foul. Oh, on the Chucks. Oh, that's going to be 15, and that negates that run and everything. It's going to bring up first down and 25. All the way back to the 25-yard line. And that's, boy, when you're trailing and you needed some momentum, that's not what you want to see.
Yeah, the 12-yard run would have been the momentum you needed, not the chop block.
Receiver to each side. Seth Moore now in the shotgun with Zeke to his left. Hand off to Zeke. He's got some room. Gets up to the middle. Breaks a couple tackles. Gets back.
Good. You got a lot of
yardage.
Some of
that yardage. Up to about the 34. 9 yards. Second down. And about 16. Miller stops in motion. Get it to Zeke again. Find some room.
He's got a first. No, he doesn't. Never mind. Look at the ball.
He gets back from the original line scrimmage. Yeah. He gets the whole way back to about the 42, so it's 3rd and 8. Very manageable now. Two hard runs up the middle. Punxsutawney hurrying things up. Same formation. Miller now on that side, and he'll stop. Zeke gets the handoff. He's going to get the first down and more. Zeke Bennett with a man to beat, and he will be chased down all the way down about the 15-yard line. Orts and Minnick have to chase him down, but there's where what happens. You keep forcing linebackers up, and you can break through. You're going to get big gains, and they're going to mark him at the 15. First and 10 for the Chucks. Keep that formation. Zeke and Seth kind of run into each other as he'll get a couple yards. That could have been a disaster, but they were able to hold on to the ball and actually get a couple yards. Second down, eight. 28-14, Chuck's trail. It's 7:35 to go, running clock, fourth quarter. Second down, eight for Punxsutawney. Ball at about the 13-yard line. Seth Moore from the shotgun. Taken by Zeke. Zeke tries to come out this way. He bounces it out. He'll make a man miss. And then he's brought down about the six.
It's going to be close.
Yep, it's going to be about a yard or two short, maybe a yard short. It's going to bring up third down. About third and one. And Redbank will take a timeout. We'll go ahead and take one and get things set up for you. 30-second timeout. You're listening to a Laurel Eichling Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsutawney.
Simplicity's Broadmoor Lawn Tractor is both high performance and comfortable to drive. The Simplicity Broadmoor is a lawn tractor with the heart of a garden tractor. With features like a heavy-duty steel frame, cast iron front axle, automotive control traction, a free-floating mower deck, and a superior operating comfort, the Broadmoor is the finest lawn tractor in the business. Visit 310 Lawn and Garden, located on Route 310 between Reynolds Hill and Punxsutawney, to test drive the Simplicity Broadmoor Lawnmower Tractor today. Simplicity, the way to a beautiful lawn. The Punxsutawney Chucks play here. FM 100.9 and AM 1540 WECZ, Punxsutawney.
Welcome back. DJ and Eric here with you. Chucks trailing by 14, but they're knocking on the door. The ball's at about the 6-yard line, third down and one.
I might give that play to Miller again, the one they used on the last touchdown drive.
They got two to this side, two receivers. They got Miller in that wing. Seth Moore under center. He'll hand it off to Zeke. Zeke will get the first down to the four. Needed one, got two. First and goal for the Chucks. Oh, excuse me, that was Landon Martz.
That was Martz.
That was Martz that got those 2 yards, and then Zeke's going to come back in. Landon Martz having a nice game tonight both ways. Shown that he can run a little bit.
He ain't the fastest guy out there, but he runs with power.
Now Zeke will be in the backfield. First and goal from the four. He'll take it. The ball's on the ground, and Seth Moore will recover it at the nine.
Oh, man.
Five-yard loss, but they'll keep the ball. Second and goal for the nine.
Wow. That's the second time Zeke has saved this.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what caused the fumble there.
6:14 on a running clock here. Final quarter, the fourth quarter, brought to you by Pneumatics. 28-14. This is a big series for the Chucks. They're down in near second and goal from the nine. They're going to spread it out. Two to each side. Zeke DeLone setback. He'll take the handoff. Comes this way. Breaks a tackle. Gets to the five. I think that was a helmet.
I think that was a helmet. No, it was not. It was the ball.
Gets to the five, third down and goal. 4-yard gain. 5:35 running clock. No question they're going to go for it here. Regardless, this is two downs, two plays to get 5 yards for a touchdown.
Yeah,
here.
Nothing fancy here. Just punch it in.
And Zeke has to fall down on at the nine, and it's fourth and goal, another 4-yard loss. And the clock will go under 5 minutes here. We're going to stop at a timeout taken by Tunksy at 5:02.
They had to.
Yeah, got to get everybody settled in here, come up with a nice 9-yard play to get this touchdown. They got to punch this in, trailing 28-14.
That is a tough set of downs here. A couple of bad snaps have set us back.
But what a game this has been thus far. It's been exciting. The fans have been into this game.
The students have been in the game. The Red Bank fans have been in the game. Both teams have been in this game. I mean, it's been an exciting high school football game here in Western Pennsylvania.
Yeah, this is what Friday nights in Western PA are all about.
Yep, this is a very good game. Here comes the Chucks. They're going to put Miller in the wing, Seth in the shotgun with Zeke to his right. Twins go to the right side. One receiver to this, Noah Weaver to this side. Fourth down and goal from the 9. Moore rolls out, looks the pass, comes across the middle, and it's deflected. And a nice job there again by Ashton Kale all over Noah Weaver. Perfect pass. It was there, but it was just great coverage. So a turnover on downs after 10 plays and trailing by 14 with 5 minutes to go. It's so important for a three out for the Chucks defense. .457 to go in this game.
Well, here's where you you bring the house.
Wagner will be in that shotgun where he's been all night. He's got Byers to his left. They need a player, it looks like. And now they're going to have to call a timeout. They're short a guy. So we'll take a timeout with them and get everything lined up here. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lowell Eye Clinic, Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsy.
Our locally owned CRW Home Center on Martha Street, Punxsy, has helped build the community since 1989, always providing customers with the highest quality products and services at competitive prices. Everyone at CRW Home Center is wishing the Chucks football team the best of luck this year. Go Chucks!
Looking for another delicious option for food after the game? Well, Layla Joe's has you covered. In support of the Varsity Chucks, we are staying open until 11 p.m. for home games starting this Friday. Bring your ticket stub and get $1 off. See you this week before and after the game.
This is Punxsy Chucks football on Fox Sports, FM 100.9.
Welcome back. 4:57 to go in the game. Chucks trail 28-14. Red Bank with the football, first and 10 from their 9. Chucks just got stopped on downs. Red Bank had to take a timeout. They only have one remaining. Wagner from the shotgun. He'll hand off to Byers. Byers tries to turn the corner, and he is going to get nothing, as we'll see what Chucks come out of that pile. Nesbitt and Martz. It's going to be a loss of 2 back to the 7, second down 12. But more importantly for Red Bank, they just want this time to run.
Yeah, 14-point lead.
See them watch that play clock a little bit closer here as we're down to 4:25 and a running clock. Still 15 on the play clock. Trips to the far side. Wagner now get things rolling with 5 seconds to go. Better hurry it up. They do get it off. It's a pick.
That was a nice
this
play.
Way. As he makes a couple guys miss. Miller and Nesbitt with the stop.
That was
out taken here by the Chucks with 4:03 to go. We'll stay right here. It's going to bring up third down and about 7, maybe 6.
Yeah, that was Byers' longest play of the night at 6 yards.
Yeah,
they've hemmed him in.
They've done a nice job on running game. Punxsy's done a great job defensively this game. I mean, there's been a couple.
Yeah.
You know, you talk about the 2 punt returns, one for a touchdown, one to the one.
One
to
the
14
one.
Points.
Right, absolutely.
So there's your, you know, other than that.
Yeah, other than that, it's been an even game.
A 50-yard touchdown pass and a 22-yard run. So it's been big plays for Red Bank.
Well, big plays, and the other big difference is Red Bank doesn't make the mistakes on the basics. You know, we weren't seeing any bad snaps, no bad exchanges. And that really hurt us tonight. You know, Punxsy can force a fumble here, get a turnover. That would be huge.
4:03 after the timeout.
Punxsutawney and Redbank each with one timeout remaining. So big third down and six. Ball at about the 13-yard line. Wagner shotgun, he'll go trips to the far side. He has Mason Kale in the backfield with him this time. Or excuse me, that's, I believe, 13, Cole Bish. Now the officials out there once again.
The Red Bank's coach just keeps walking out on the field.
Now we're going to have the officials come over and talk to Punxsutawney.
27 years of coaching wrestling. If I said hello to the ref, I got a warning.
As Coach Nichols getting an explanation.
The question is, why do you keep letting him run out on the field? The answer is, I'm not going to throw a flag.
So a little delay in the action here. Again, Punxsutawney will travel to Central Clarion next week. We'll be there as well. As now I think we're set to go. Big third down here for the Chucks defense. Third down six, ball at the 13-yard line of Red Bank. Wagner rolls to his left, looking to throw, hits a guy, and it's in and out.
Oh,
it'll be fourth down.
If they could have popped that up a little higher.
And that was intended for Ashton Kale, but Red Bank's going to have to punt. Threw him just a little bit behind him there and had some zip on him.
Yeah.
And it goes incomplete. And Tate Minnick will be standing around his goal line to punt this one. Zeke Bennett will be in Red Bank territory. Minnick and...
Oh, boy.
Penalty marker. Oh, we would have wanted that one. Nice shorty.
Yeah, Punxsutawney almost got to that.
And I think we're going to have a false start.
He's going to be punting out of the end zone. Punxsutawney almost got to that ball.
So a little movement on up front there for Red Bank. 3:56 remaining in this game. The fourth quarter brought to you by New Medics. Halfway into the end zone now is Minnick. Zeke standing just at about the 42-yard line. Punxsutawney should get really good field position here.
Yeah. I still come for the ball.
And this one gets us out. Zeke will get it at the 45. Trying to make a guy move, and Byers is going to wrestle him down. But
nice return.
Punxsutawney starting inside the 40. Now a penalty marker.
Yeah, we're going to get a flag on Punxsutawney.
And that penalty marker over there, see what we're going to have.
All I know is I saw a Red Bank guy laying out where the flag's at.
See what they're going to call there. Punxsutawney looks like they're going to go backwards.
Yeah, it's a 15-yarder.
Personal foul on Punxsutawney. All the way back near the 50. It's going to be in Punxsutawney territory now, all the way back to the 45-yard line. So 3:46 remaining.
How does that end up being a 20?
That's on
2-yard penalty.
I'm trying to think. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out where that. Nevertheless,
if it was a dead ball foul, the play was over.
Yeah.
So it should have been a 15-yard penalty from where the tackle was made.
Seth Moore looking to pass. He's got Noah Weaver. It's just
Noah couldn't find it.
He ran a nice little wheel route there, and Zeke another penalty marker. Going to be a hold on
Chuck.
So it's going to be holding, so that'll be no play as they'll make it first and 20. Ball now back to the 35-yard line. 3:41 to go here in the game. Chuck's trailing 28-14. Punxsutawney with just one timeout remaining. Seth from the shotgun, twin receivers each side. Hand off to Zeke. Zeke will be brought down by Boy, is he Adams. He'll get about 4 yards. Brings up second down and 16. Clock continue to run at 3:20 here in this game. Make sure you stay tuned for our Punxsutawney McDonald's post-game show along with our Garagazzoni Player of the Game brought to you by Jefferson Machine. Twins, look this way. It's Noah Weaver at the 45 and gets across to 50 to the 49. It's going to bring up third down and 4. Nice run there by nice throw and catch. More to Weaver.
How many yards we get?
About 12 yards.
Thank you.
Seth will hand off to Zeke. Zeke will get the first down. Gets it outside. Makes a man miss. And a nice tackle there by Klaus. But it's enough for a first down to the 40.
About 9 yards for Zeke.
First and 10. Ball at the 40. 2:35 and a running clock to go. Again, Seth from the shotgun looks this way. And
he's got to quit looking at Noah.
And he had Weaver again, but they had three guys around Noah that time and almost intercepted. Fortunately, it was dropped. The clock stopped at 2:27 to go in the game.
That one would have spelled trouble if he'd been able to hang on to it.
Yeah. Twins each side once again, Seth. With Zeke to his left. Going to go to Bennett. And he'll get a yard. And that's
they
it.
Had that
39.
Out.
Hurrying it up here. As they need to. We're down to 2:15 the running clock. Third down and 9. Under center. Goes Moore. He'll have Miller as the wing, Zeke in the backfield, twin to the far side.
Oh,
Zeke
my.
With the run, he's going to lose a yard.
Yeah, that was good defense.
And fourth and 10, as Punxsutawney will take a timeout, their final timeout, 1:51 to go. We'll stay here. Again, want to make sure you stay tuned to our Punxsutawney McDonald's post-game show. It's been an exciting game here at Jack LaMarca Stadium tonight. Jefferson Machine, Gary Garzoni, player of the game, will be announced. .151 to go here in the game. It's been a fun game. Punxsutawney trailing by 14 and like you said, Eric, it's just been kind of, you know, a couple mistakes here and there, a couple big plays on Red Bank's part, and that's the difference in the game. It's Punxsutawney has played this team equally.
Yeah, they played them equally. A few small mistakes on Punxsutawney's part, some huge plays. Three big plays.
Three big plays. Three big plays.
Three big plays.
I mean, they really have, especially in the second half, have held this offense in check of the Bulldogs. So fourth and 10, Punxsutawney here down. Basically, it's their final opportunity. The ball's at the Red Bank 40. Twin receiver to each side. Seth Moore will be in shotgun. Zeke will be to his right as a sidecar. Back to pass. It's going to be to Miller. Miller's going to make things happen, and he is going to be just a yard short. Nice hustle by Ashton Kale, and he's going to stop him 1 yard short at the 31-yard line. Needed to get to the 30. And it's a turnover on downs. Boy, I like that play. Getting Miller the ball and see if he can get it. And he just got a shoestring tackled a yard short. And that's going to make it tough for the Chucks here. 1:45 to go. Red Bank will take their final timeout.
I would expect for them to just kneel.
I mean, they can. Punxsutawney can't stop it. 25 seconds. I mean, they could almost run it out. And the officials kind of help you with that a little bit. They take a little bit longer to set the ball and so forth. So,
yeah, I mean,
what an exciting game here tonight. I said that several times, but it was a fun game. I think a lot of people were entertained by the game tonight. I think Redbank is surprised at the game a little bit. Punxsutawney come out and played hard. And playing
hard. Yeah, right to the end. That's what they have played hard on every play. You know, I just, you know, you let Mike know down there at Red Bank, I'll be volunteering with you again this year, and I will be out on the mat arguing with the official, just so he knows. Mike wouldn't expect anything less.
Good guy.
Oh,
and looks like they will just kneel on it, so.
It's a smart thing to do. Don't risk getting someone hurt.
Wagner goes under center, kneels down. And it's a show of respect to both teams because then they don't start the clock.
All you have to do is start the clock.
Yeah. No, flag. I think she was just basically like they didn't start the clock.
Yeah, I think he was just trying to get the attention.
Yeah.
But that's why the referee threw the flag, I believe, is to
now
indicate that now it's first and 10, clock running, and they'll be able to kneel.
It should be second down.
Well, I think they're going to rerun the. They're just going to run it down, make it second and 10. Right now, there you go.
So everything, now we'll get this close to a minute before it's over. So two more kneel downs, this one and one more, and that'll do it for the game. Wagner again goes under, and it'll go down. And with 40, one more kneel down, that'll do it. The Chucks are going to fall to 2-1 in the season. A hard fought
2-1.
28-14 loss to the Bulldogs, who will go to 3-0.
You never like to lose, and you don't want to celebrate a loss, but these boys should be proud of the way they battled tonight.
Yep, just one more kneel down, and that'll do it. What a game. I'll tell you what, there's a lot of guys, they need to hold their heads high. That was a
absolutely
very good football game, hard fought, and was in that game all the way to the end. So congratulations to both teams. Good football game played by both. Congratulations to Red Bank. They'll go to 3-0 on the team on the season. Chucks will fall to 2-1. We will take a two-minute break. When we come back, we'll have our Punxsutawney McDonald's postgame show for you. You're listening to a Laurel Eye Clinic Jefferson County High School Sports Night on Fox Sports Punxsutawney.
It's 8 o'clock, honey. Get up. You're going to be late for work.
What? It's still dark out. Hold on. That's not an 8, dear. That's a 5. It's 5 o'clock. You've not been able to see when you first wake up. You know, you should really get a LASIK consultation from Laurel Eye Clinic.
What? It can't be. Wait, where's my glasses? You're wrong.
I love you, dear, but no, I'm not. Before I go back to bed, save Laurel Eye Clinic's number on your phone, would you? 1-800-494-2020. And you may want to bookmark their website, too. LaurelEye.com.
Ooh, honey, look. It says that LASIK consultations are free. I'm going to call them today. Honey?
Call the Laurel Eye Clinic today at 1-800-494-2020 or visit LaurelEye.com to learn more about what LASIK and Laurel Eye can do for you, as well as our fantastic 24-month